Hey guys, welcome to my channel Three Sisters. In today's video, we'll be seeing about the periodic property of elements, which is valency. Valency might be a bit tough to understand at the beginning, but I'm here to make it more easy for you. Welcome to Three Sisters, and without further ado, let's get started into our topic, valency. So what is valency? Like, we'll see what is valency, the overall definition first. So valency is nothing but, like, we all know that in nature, if you see around yourself, what everything, like, we can't see like individual elements, like this. You can't say that this, for example, a wall is not only made up of sodium or hydrogen or oxygen. So we can see that most elements do not occur in the nature of free nature. We can't say that they are, like, without the combined state they are occurring. Like, they are getting combined and then only they are occurring as matter around us, like the all objects around us. So all of the representative elements they will always, like, react with other elements and to form compounds. These compounds only will later become all the things around us, right? So what is valency? The combining capacity of the element is called valency. Like, the combining capacity is nothing but how much the element can combine, or, like, for element to combine, it needs to give or take electrons. Like, according to that, the capacity of that is only called as valency. The combining capacity is, like, it is, we always compare it to the hydrogen, chlorine, oxygen. It's because valency will also be described as the number of hydrogen atoms and the number of chlorine atoms, or the twice of the number of oxygen atoms. So, for example, if you take H2O, in that we can also say the valency is H2O, one atom is there. So the twice the number of O is the valency of that particular compound. H2O, O1, 1 into 2, 2. And hydrogen, the number of hydrogen atoms will also be the measure of the valency. So, 2 hydrogens are there. So, 2. So, anyway, if you see the combining capacity, which is the valency, will be 2. I hope you understood the H2O example. So, the number of chlorine atom, NaCl. In NaCl, the valency of Cl is 1. That compound NaCl is 1, because the number of chlorine atoms present in that is 1. So we can also say that the combining capacity, which is nothing but valency, is a measure of the number of oxygen atoms, twice the number of oxygen atoms, number of hydrogen atoms, and the number of chlorine atoms. This is something important to remember. And valency of all group is generally the same. Group is nothing but the vertical row. Like the row, for example, this vertical row, this is nothing but the group of the element, the group in the periodic table. So generally, in a group, all elements in one group will have the same valency. For example, if you take the first alkaline metals, all their valencies are 1, and alkaline earth metals 2. So this is an important property. Like, valency itself is the most important property, because by using that only, like, because of valency only, two elements are reacting with each other. So an alkali, as I have said before, alkali metal is univalent. Since alkali, this is the 1A group, alkali metals are the 1A group elements, they are all univalent. In the sense, 1 is their valency. And alkaline earth metal, which is 2A group elements, they are all bivalent. In the sense, the valency will be 2. And some of the p-buck elements, in the sense, the middle block of the periodic table, and the transition element, they will exhibit variable valencies, not like alkaline and alkaline earth metals. But in the p-block and the d-block transition elements, there are few elements which, like, they will put, like, more than one valency, like variable valency. For example, sulfur, the valency of sulfur in sulfur dioxide is 4, and valency of sulfur trioxide is 6. So it will differ from the compound to compound for few elements, not all elements, for only few elements, like sulfur, iron, gold, silver, like aurum, they are all like they will have variable valencies. You have to remember the variable valencies because they are like exceptions, right? And iron is divalent, like iron is divalent in ferrous state and trivalent in ferric state. So generally here one important point, an extra point I'm telling is here ferrous, as you have seen, the ferrous is nothing but used for roll, O-U-S, it's like suffix which is used for the lower valency. 2 is the lower valency for iron, like the 2 and 3 is the variable valency showed by iron, 2 is lesser than that. So we can say 2 as O-U-S, like instead of telling it like it's divalent in this one, we can say as ferrous, because ferrous means it has 2 as its valency. So it'll be easy for us to tell which, what is the valency of that element, like how much, like for variable valency, for the elements which have a variable valency, we can easily guess it with this. Ferrous is used for, O-U-S suffix is used for the lower number. If 1 and 2 are the variable valency, 1 means O-U-S will be used and 2 means I-C will be used. So here, ferrous in a sense, divalent, if it's divalent, this 2 is the lower state. So O-U-S is used and 3 is the above, the greater than 2, you know. IC is the used. I hope you got what I'm saying. And next, copper. Copper is also, as you can see here also, monovalent and cuprous state. See, monovalent is the less. Mono means one. It has one is the lower valency. So cuprous, O-U-S is used. And divalent, IC. So there's a mistake here. Please correct it and don't mind it. So you have got what I'm saying, right? So that is the general idea of it, to identify which is the valency for variable valency elements. And the valency of elements may also be zero. So for zero for 8 group elements, which are the noble gases, it will be zero for them. It can be 1, 2 or 3 and many more. It can't be a negative value. It can't be a negative value and it can't be a fractional value. For example, sulfur also. Sulfur has 3 valencies, which is 2, 4, 6. Like, it can exhibit 1, 2 or 3, but it cannot, the value cannot be negative value or it cannot be fractional. Because it doesn't make sense if it is fractional, right? So, yeah, that is about this slide. Next, we'll see about some properties of valency itself. So, valency is 0 for uncombined state. If the element is not combined, it's in its raw state, then it is 0 for that element. And valency of 0 group elements, which is nothing but 8th group elements, the 8A group, the valency will be 0 because they are 8A group and they are noble gases, so they won't react. So the electron present in the outermost shell, they will generally represent the valency. So these in the valence electron, in the valency shell are called valence electrons. And generally the valency of the elements with fewer number of electrons in the valence shell is the number of valence electrons. In case it's 4 or more, the valency of the valency electrons is 4 or more, the general valency is 8 minus the number of valence electrons. The maximum valency exceeded by an element in Roman notation is 8. So what they are telling is the electrons present in the outermost element, like the outermost shell, for example, the outermost shell here, for 2 shells, so that means the outermost shell means valence electron, we'll say, right? So how we can tell valency with that number of valence electrons, like the, in the sense, if there are less than 4, like 1, 2, 3, that itself will be the valency. But if it's more than 4 electrons, then we should usually minus the valency, 8 minus the number of valence electrons to find the valency of that. So that one, and the maximum number is 8. Like, 8, after 8, no valency can exist, because 8 is the maximum number of electrons in the outermost shell it can be. So 8 is the maximum valency exhibited by any number, like we have found. And valency of osmium, osmium has 8 when in oxygen tetroxide and xenon tetroxide, the valency of osmium xenon is 8. And the valency with respect to hydrogen increases from 1 to 4 and then decreases to 1 from 1A group. The valency, it will increase from 1 to 4 and then it will decrease to 1 from the 1A to 8A group. First it will increase and then it will slowly decrease from 1 to, like from the 1A to 8A, it will slowly decrease and then it will increase and decrease. There are variations. First it will increase and then decrease. And the periodicity of the valency can be seen with the successive valency shown in hydrides of oxyfluorides in each period. So we can say that like the valency is shown in hydrides, or we can see that the periodicity means the number of time it's coming. We can see that itself, like for the same group itself, it will be the same and it will slowly increase, kind of like that. And the periodicity, we have just now completed. And by using the valency of, elements, the formula can also be predicted. Like if you know what is the valency, we can easily predict the formula. Like by using the valency, we can predict the formula of a compound. And of those elements, we can see how it will form. Like how the chemical formula will be there if it reacts with this. Like we can easily tell that because we will know how much valence electrons will be present if we calculate it, right? So we will know that and we can calculate it. And the valency of many electrons is not constant. So for many elements, for like sulfur, copper, iron, we don't know which variable valency will exhibit in which time, right? So we prefer it to write the formula of the compound, like in writing the formula instead of just predicting it, because we might not know which will come, right? So we will be preferring the writing things to get a clear idea of it. So this is it about the valency, guys. I hope you understood. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any doubts in this video, please do leave them down in the comment box below. Thank you for watching. Do like, share and subscribe to Sri Sisters. And for detailed notes, check out my Instagram. The ID is @Sri_Sisters. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye.